Hello, 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 everybody, everybody. I am Steven, I am Sam, I am Sam, I am Sam. Steven, 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 Steven. AKA, 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 Master Fennel, Master Fennel. Alright, hello, yes, I kind of was singing along with the music here because I kind of like the Sacred Grove slash Lost Woods theme that's in these games. But yes, I am SIMSteven, also known as Mr. Fenrel, and we're back with Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, and, well, no surprise to anyone, we're at the Sacred Grove, ready to retrieve the Master Sword and break the curse on Link, allowing him to revert back to his human form, because it is a dark magic that has been cast upon him, as Zelda told us when we were there in Hyrule Castle. Who also saved Minna, who is now able to dwell within the Realm of Light, along with us Light Dwellers. But before we can even get into the Sacred Grove, we have a Howling Stone. And this should be a very familiar melody to any fan of Zelda, because it is, well, a very iconic tune. Think Wolf Link could hit the high notes there, so he went down an octave at that last bit there. But we have something of a familiar face from the first two games on the Nintendo 64, and well, since this game is strongly connected to those two games, we have a little Skull Kid to chase down. Thankfully, he's not dropping a gigantic moon in our heads this time around, but, we have a bunch of these dolls, which we are gonna just keep on spawning as we try to navigate the Sacred Grove, aka the Lost Woods, because it's essentially the same exact thing, just in a different location in the game. I don't even know if it's there is any difference whatsoever between both locations, but in this game they call it the Sacred Grove. But anyways, in order to beat Skull Kid and get to the Sacred Grove, we have to track down Skull Kid and attack him several times. Each and every time we attack him, he'll open up a new pathway for us to travel down, and, well, that's pretty much just all we gotta do, rinse and repeat in order to beat or get through the Sacred Grove here. He's kind of playing tricks on us, kind of is pretty usual for the Skull Kid, but pretty much just gotta listen out, and I'm gonna try and listen out for him. Pretty much gotta look for all these little passageways and listen for his little horn in the background. And if you can hear him playing his horn, then it means you're probably pretty close to where he is. If not, well, you're probably just gonna be wandering around here quite a bit. I think this is one location he can appear at later, but just pretty much every time we beat him or attack him, he'll make one of these tree stump wall things disappear and then run through it. And then we gotta follow him, and I probably lost track of where he came from this time. So, yeah, like that one, that's gonna be a door later. I have no idea which direction he went off to, so I am just gonna run around wandering lost in the Lost Woods, naturally. Essentially, that's the place where we are. Oh, and I hear him there. I actually saw him up there on the left on that tree trunk there. And I think we kind of swim beyond this waterfall. And sorry about that. I had a bit of cough there. And I'll probably cut that out. But, you just gotta repeat this several times. And yes, he will summon those creepy doll things over and over again. They're infinitely spawning. I don't think they drop rupees, so I don't think you can use that as a rupee farming technique. So, excuse me, still got a bit of a dry spot in my throat. I probably should go grab some water in a bit. But yeah, we just gotta keep following the Skull Kid until we beat his ass a couple more times. And then we'll be through these lost woods here. And where he went to this time. Did he go back this way? I don't remember which direction he went. I probably should be paying a little bit more attention to which direction he runs in, but I can hear him now. And where are you? He must be directly above me. Yeah, I kind of heard him. I got headphones on, so I can kind of hear him better than probably stereo surround sound, if that's what you're listening to this video on. But I think we just gotta go up this way now, and then I believe there should be a doorway that'll lead us to the Skull Kids again. Here we go. Got him three times. That's kind of his laugh. Kind of my laugh, too, for what it's worth. Alright, da-da-da. Let's jump down, and hopefully he went this way. It's the nearest doorway we can go into. I don't know if we can hear it, but I can just barely hear his trumpet from over there in the corner. We're in the arena now. So this is the last time we'll have to really face off with him again. But he's just kind of toying with us, playing with us, as he would like to put it. But now, it's on! He mad, bro. He mad. And once again, we're going to ignore those creepy dolls and just pretty much just get right up to them and attack him. Oh wait, no, I forget. There's actually a trick to this. What you need to do is try to attack the dolls until there is like nothing on the ground. And then when he's blowing his horn, you need to climb up to him really quickly and should be able to get a hit on him. Otherwise, he'll just teleport away and pretty much play keep away. So yeah, beat the dolls until he's ready to summon some more. And kind of get in there and get a good hit in. Not exactly a boss fight, technically, if that's what you're wondering, but he does... he could count as like a mini boss, but he's not actually doing this to be, mean. Well, he does do a lot of pranks in the games he appears in, but really, he's not doing it because he's evil. He's just lonely and like wants some friends and stuff. That's kind of his character, anyways. Get up there, please. Thank you. There we go. 3 hits and he's done. Bye. Yeah, he was just having fun with us. That's all he was doing. But that leads to a new pathway once we beat him there. And we should be very close to it. You know what I'm talking about. It. But, yeah, this looks like a very sacred grove indeed. Alright, so... probably getting into the most hated part of this game, and we've got a puzzle coming up. So let's just howl out Zelda's lullaby, since that's apparently a very magical song that opens doorways everywhere. Especially did so in the Ocarina. Pretty much every game where you can actually play it on an instrument, it'll open some doorway somewhere. Especially in Ocarina of Time, where it became more of a thing where Link would actually play music to do various things. Zelda's lullaby did a lot of things where you have to open doorways with it, like the entrance to Zora's domain, and I think some graveyards in the Kakariko graveyard. Bunch of things in Ocarina of Time where that song came into play. Came into play, get it? But, yeah. By howling out Zelda's lullaby here, we got this puzzle here. One that many, many people hate. Where we got these two guardian statues, and You pretty much just got to direct them to those little circular pillars over there next to the one that's talking right there. And basically, they do the opposite of what you do. And so, in order for you to really solve this puzzle, you have to manipulate them into pretty much jumping into the right spot. And I think in order for you to do this, you need to not only adjust yourself, but try and get them in the correct spots. So, I'm just doing this strictly from memory. But I remember going up around the horns of this little heart-shaped thing here. And I believe you need to try and get them to go around like that. I forget exactly what to do. If you run into them, or if you land on the same platform that they do, you'll get crushed and have to start over. I don't know if it does any damage, but I do believe... how do I go about doing this? Yeah, I do believe you'll just have to keep at this until it actually works out right. I've kind of got it close here. Oh crap, I probably shouldn't have done that one. That was probably a bad move there. Because, well, if they try to jump towards in the outer border here, they'll actually just stop in place. Can I do this? No, that doesn't work. Yeah, I'm just going to kind of try and finagle this until I get it right. I think I've actually got it good here. I think if we... go sideways... I don't know. I don't know if I'm actually going to get this right here, but I'm going to hope and try. So we got them on the corners, and that looks like a good position here. Oh wait, have we actually done it? In one try! Woohoo! It only took me maybe 2 minutes. I've heard horror stories where it takes some people like 30 minutes to get this right, but it's pretty much just try and get them so they're two spaces away, and then just kind of finagle it a little bit until you can get them on their platforms. Just kind of go around the borders a little bit, and there we go. Go now to the sacred place, beast. We yield passage to the sacred grove. Alright, so, doors open. Nothing between us and our grand prize for doing the sacred grove. Alright, so, there it is. The Master Sword, the Blade of Legend, and the most iconic blade in the series. Accepted you as its master. This thing is the embodiment of the evil magic that Zan cast on you. It's definitely different from our tribe's shadow magic. Careful, if you touch it, you'll turn back into a beast. This thing is too dangerous. It's probably for the best if we just leave it here, huh? On the other hand, if we kept it, you'd be able to transform into a beast anytime you wanted. Yes, since Aunt was kind enough to give this to us, we should be thankful to use it all we can. If you need it, just call me. I want to keep a low profile, so I'll hide in your shadow when you're human, but I can change you whenever. You can be a wolf anytime you like. Also, thanks to this thing, you can warp wherever you want by switching into wolf form. But hey, listen, Link. Hey, listen! Ogre of Time reference once again. I've got a little favor to ask. Well, you might coming with me to find something called the Mirror of Twilight. It's in somewhere in Hyrule. Yes, the Mirror of Twilight, our last potential link to Zant. Alright, and Minna hides in our shadow, because, as she says, she's kinda not able to mingle with people of the world of light. Well, we're kinda the exception, but if anyone else saw her, well, they'd probably freak out. same thing goes when we are in Wolflink. So, she's not exactly lying, but... there are times we can't transform into Wolflink, especially in populated areas. But as badass as the sword is, we're doing a wooden sword run. So unfortunately, we're going to take it off and put back my Hylian shield. We're still going to be using the Hylian shield, but this is supposed to be something of a challenge run, even though we haven't really had much of a challenge. But yeah, we will need to use the Master Sword for like, I think, one boss fight. There is one exception where we need to use it. Otherwise, the boss fight will become unbeatable if we don't use the Master Sword in that. Thankfully, it's not like till the very end. It's one of the last dungeon bosses. And yes, I did look this up off screen. But we should be able to do like 99% of the game with just the wooden sword. Unfortunately, yeah, we're not going to be using the Master Sword other than that one time. Anywho, before we leave the Sacred Grove, because we can warp out of here, and that's not exactly how we're supposed to get out of here, I'm going to pick up this male snail. Kind of a bit of a tongue twister there. There is also a female snail, but we cannot actually get her right now. Because there is something here that we're supposed to do later in the game. And we will be coming back here, but this is a one-time trip for now. So we can also go back into the Sacred Grove, the Lost Woods portion of it at least, and get a thing or two here as well. Couldn't do this earlier because we were not in Wolflink form, or we were not able to access our human form. But now that we have hands, we can blow up this rock, and well, we're gonna try out our nifty blue new little stone that we got just a little bit ago. And transform into wolf anytime we like. Got ourselves a pole here that we're gonna kill. And grab its soul. Might as well take this while we're here. And if you accidentally warp out of here and forget to collect this now, you can come back later, but only when the game lets you. Also, by blowing up that rock, we can actually dig here in this digging spot and enter a little bit of a cave here. I'm going to transform back into human, because I think there's some things we need to beat in here as human Link. Block you with our shield. Get off me, please. There we go. Alright, kill you. And typically when you have a small cave like this, you want to first focus on killing every single enemy that's in here. And then we'll worry about looking for treasure later. But there is a treasure in here that I definitely want to get. Pull you down with our Gale Boomerang. And take you down. Got yourselves a heart. There must be one more enemy around here. Right there. Two, actually. Wow. There are a lot of you guys in here. What? Three, four more? I must have just kind of got on around the outside or something. I don't know. What was that, like 10 of these things? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It was like 8 of them. But we did it. We killed them all. And we get ourselves a treasure chest. And very important thing we want to get, because I remember this thing containing a piece of heart. Yep. Memory's not too bad after all. Let's get that. And typically, whenever you're in one of these caves as well, you want to look around the outside. Because there are sometimes little treasure chests around the outside which contain rupees. And since we won't be coming back here for a while, I do my best to make sure and see if there is anything in this little cave here. No, it does not look like it. I'm not cutting the grass because I don't want accidental rupee pickups. But yeah, let's get out of here. And I do want to check the Sacred Grove for one last thing. If not, I'll cut ahead to when we warp out of here. And I'm going to transform into a wolf as I search for this thing, because there should be one more Poe in here. But I don't know if I can actually collect it yet. Okay, yeah, unfortunately, we can't backtrack through the Sacred Grove. I actually had to climb this vine to get out of the area where we fought the Skull Kid earlier. But the way we need to go to get to that Poe is blocked, and we can't actually get into later in the game. So, unfortunately, that one's going to have to wait. So instead, we're going to warp on out of here. Don't worry if you didn't collect those three things, the piece of heart, the Poe, and the male snail. We can get them later, like I said before, because we'll be making a return trip. For now, though, we're going to be doing side quests. And a lot of side quests. Because we had a lot that we could have done prior to doing the Lakebed Temple, but I decided to hold off on that for the time being. Because I wanted to get the ability to warp around freely. Yes, this is the main reason why I wanted to rush the game a little bit, is because once you get through the whole section with, you know, Zant wounding Midna and then making her a denizen of the Realm of Light, and, you know, getting that orange stone that transformed this into a wolf, this is the main reason why I wanted to hold off on doing side quests, because you can warp around freely and at your leisure. And you can also get a lot of these Poe souls while you're at it. And it's best to get all these Poe souls as soon as you're able to transform into Human Link. To get around this guy. I don't even want to bother with these guys. I can't see worth a crap. So we're coming back into this cave here because, in case you remember, there is a Poe here we can do anything with the first time around. And go away, please. You're annoying me, bats. Thank you. And you, Tech Type. But we're going to go grab that Poe because we couldn't get him earlier because of the fact that we couldn't transform into a wolf inside of the cave, because there are those spider webs that are blocking your way. And you need to be Human Link with the lantern in order to burn the spider webs away. And in order to grab the Poe's soul from the back of this place, you need to be able to transform into Wolf Link. So they did a fairly good job of making sure that you can actually collect Poe souls before this point in time in the game. But like I said before, there is that one in the Faerun Woods that we collected prior to when we were actually supposed to grab it. Because they didn't apparently consider that we would actually go back there and do that whole minute jumping segment in that poisonous mist area. So, yeah, we got one that the developers forgot to take out. I think that guy is over here. Maybe there he is, actually. Also, one thing I probably could point out is if you're in wolf form, you can actually use senses and be able to see a little bit better. So, even though senses normally make it harder to see and just kind of makes it difficult to see in this little area around you. If you're in a completely dark area, it actually makes it slightly easier to see. Because we got this grass that we wouldn't be able to see before. I'm still kind of stumbling around aimlessly. I'm kind of just following along on the mini-map here. But yeah. It does make things slightly easier to see, even though, you know, if you were to be Wolf Link, it'd be, or Human Link, it'd be completely pitch black like it is here. You can at least see a little bit as Wolf Link with our senses on. Because otherwise, well, there it is, a bit of a difference, as you can see. So let's dash our way out of here and get out of this cave. We're completely done with that cave now. Good thing. There is another one kind of like that, and there are a ton of rupees in that cave. Oh wait, I don't think I need to transform back into human. We wanted to warp. And yes, you have to turn into a wolf anytime you want to warp, so that's kind of a slightly bad thing. Anyways, I think... Yeah, let's do this real quick, because I mentioned it earlier in one of the previous episodes. We're kind of getting up there in our rupee counts, so I would like to go to Kakariko Village and get started on another side quest. And there are a few major side quests that I'd like to highlight in this video. I don't know if I'll get to all of them in one video, but... Well, hey there, Epona, right where I left you. I like to leave Epona there once I no longer have much of a use for her because, well, she's around a lot of people, ones that will care for her, including Ilya, who I think is just hanging around here in Renato's little temple here. But yeah, she's kind of with good friends and all that, and there's also Watery Cole. So, yeah, she's taken care of by all these people when I'm not taking care of my own damn horse. Yeah. Well, here's Ilya. Lake, you have gone through so much trouble for me. I'm so sorry. Colin and the others have told me so much about you, Link. Tell me that you're brave and kind, that you hurt very well. That must mean you're... That means you must be a good rider, huh? Oh, and the name of that horse of yours is Epona, right? Epona! Oh, is something coming back to her? What a lovely... Oh, crap. Almost, not quite. Alright, she was just saying something that alludes to how we knew her at the beginning of the game before she lost her memory. Yeah, I just wanted to check up on her a little bit there. But the thing I really wanted to go for is in... The Melo Mart. Yeah, we're gonna get started on the side quest because we should be able to do it now. I know I came back to check here before the Light Temple, but I don't believe we were able to do this back then. But there's a Gordon sitting outside the Melo Mart here. Bunyara, Bunyara, Hanyara, Pinyara. Eek! Long ago, you would come, my brother. Tell me, my brother, did you not see a young Gord in trouble in Castletown? I'd go to his aid this moment. With that bridge still needing repairs, it is impossible. Perhaps his fortunes will turn, for it looks like the Melo Mart is raising money to repair the bridge. This is a fine thing, my brother. Perhaps you might consider a contribution to their fundraising to help me and mine. Alright, well, yeah, that's kind of what I was saying. We got a lot of rupees and we need to put them somewhere. So, why not for a good cause? Let's build a bridge! Welcome to the Melo Mart! I have heard from a reliable source that shops in Hyrule Castletown are gouging prices, crushing folks under the thumb of commerce. Well, fear not, brother, for the Melo Mart. Wait, I pushed the button too fast and didn't read that. I think he said something like they're raising funds to rebuild the bridge. Phase 1, repair the broken bridge leading to East Castletown to the field in order to improve traffic. phase two. Yeah! Buy the Castle Town shop and sell products to the town at reduced prices. You have heard me right, brother. There is a problem. The finances for the execution of this glorious plan are lacking. Please, brother, offer some financial support to aid us in the purchase of the Castle Town shop for the benefit of the people. All right, sure, why not? You're 1,000 rupees short of funding for the bridge repairs. We need that bridge for a steady flow of goods to Castletown. We must bring the cost of goods down. Okay, yeah, let's donate everything. I don't think I have any use for money right now. So we have 602 left to go. Let's talk to Mail himself, I forget. It was male or female, I forget. You never know what the deal is, baby.
Hey, Link, buy something.
Yeah, this all sucks. Sorry, bud.
Time is money. If you're done shopping, you're wasting both. I heard there's a lot of price gouging going to shops in Castle. People are pretty upset, I hear.
I should make it more menacing.
I loathe people who take advantage of poor, unwashed masses. Get to my Castletown shop so I can finance a shop there!
Okay, hail to the demon baby, we shall do that. I just emptied my entire wallet just for you, oh Lord and Savior. Or should I say Dark Lord and Savior? Anywho, let's see here, there's a bad thing down here. I thought that Zora boy had gotten better, but he's been really depressed lately. He doesn't try to make friends with anyone. Every day he just gets up and goes straight to the graveyard. It's really weird. I might as well check on him. At least we know he's alright, isn't he? I'm not really sure. Not 100% sure. Might as well go take a look and, you know, check up on him since we were the ones who did bring him here to get him back to health. So, let's see how he's doing. We never really did get to tell him about his mother after all, but eh. The problems of being a silent protagonist. Wait. So we're not going to be able to. Anyways, let's check up on Prince Rallis. So I guess he's also kind of in the same situation as the kids from Ordon, in that he's also a long ways from home, although I guess he could just jump down in the pond there and take the shortcut back to Lake Hilly and then swim all the way back up to the Zoras to me from there. I mean, Zoras had no problem swimming up rapids. I mean, we saw the shopkeeper aid for the Isa back in the boat rental shop, and she had no problem towing an entire canoe with her upstream up the rapids. So apparently he could go back home if he wanted to. Is your name Link? My mother came to me in a dream. She showed me your image. She spoke to me of a youth who would save our domain and steer my fate. One named Link. I must thank you for all you've done. If there's anything I can ever do for you, please tell me. Please. Unfortunately, we've pretty much got nothing for you right now. We'll remember that for later, though, because he does come back for a bit of story later. But we'll have to remember him for later. We're gonna go back into town. And I don't think we really need to check up on Talo. I think he's still up on top of the watch post looking out for evil and all that. And the only other person I think of any importance, aside from Barnes, is Luda? I believe that's her name? Donald's daughter. I don't know if we saw her in here a minute ago, but we're going to take a look for her real quick. Oh, and Colin, of course. I can't forget about Colin. I don't know where those two are hanging out at. I'm not entirely sure. We're probably going to take a look for them, and if we don't find them, well, we won't find them. For now, though, I'm just going to wander around and probably cut things out here until I'm ready to resume. Oh, there they are right there, right in front of me. I didn't actually have to go very far. They're in that hotel place that they've been staying whenever anyone got injured in this place. Link, the Zora child has opened his eyes and is up and about. But all he does is go to the graveyard behind the sanctuary and pray. All day, from morning until night, he prays. Poor Zora boy, he must have been through something awful. I hope he will start feeling better soon. Well, he did lose his mother, after all, so that's probably what's been eating at him. Oh, Link, I heard from the shaman that Ilya might be able to get her memory back. Yeah, and the Zora boy opened his eyes. Yeah, I thought those both were pretty good things, but Ilya and the Zora boy seem pretty sad still. Ilya and the Zora boy both went out. Ilya goes to sanctuary every day, and I think she prays there. Zora boy prays too every day. He goes to the graveyard and stays for hours. How can I make them be happy again? Well, you know what? I'll leave that to you, because I've got a world to save, Colin, and you got to be the brave little boy now and help them get their spirits up. It's about what you can do, I suppose. Anyways, I think we're done here for the time being. There is one little Easter egg I'd like to show off real quick. Remember when I was saying you can actually transform into Wolf Link in populated areas? Let's show that off real quick here. If you transform here, it would scare someone. You don't want to do that, do you? So yeah, you gotta be out of sight whenever you transform. Otherwise, people will freak out. We're kind of an incognito hero in this game. So we are out of sight if we go all the way around here. If we walk back into the village during the day. Wow! It's a monster! Everybody, run! Yep, and everybody got scared away because one little stray wolf. Yep. So no Gorons, no people, everybody's gone. Bethel's gone, she's singing on the road. Yep, we're just one scary little wolf eating. Alright, so let's go around the other side of the gate. Maybe warp out of here if we can. I don't know if you can even warp in the village once that happens. Oh, wait, no, you can actually transform into human there. Okay, so let's go back and try and warp. You know what? This is one of those things that has been improved in the HD remaster. In that you don't actually have to go through the menu and select transform into human and warp anymore. Those will actually be on the Wii U gamepad touchscreen, so you can just hit that and it'll happen automatically. You don't have to talk to Minna every single time. Not that that's a bad thing, but it does get a bit, menu heavy when you have to do this all the time. Anywho, we're going to go back to the Zora's domain because there are a few things of great importance here, some really good upgrades. And then, I think maybe in the next episode, we're not ending things off just yet, but I think in the next episode we're going to make that primarily heart pieces and postals. Speaking of postals, one thing... Oh, wait. Crap, I don't have any money. We might have to make a quick stop at Castle Town real quick. But we've never been in this door here, and we're going to explore this little fishing hole that's beyond here. But yeah, the thing about postals is that you cannot actually, kill poles out in the field unless it's nighttime. And you've done the events we just did where we get the Master Sword. Poles will not normally appear in the field until after you've done that. Actually, I think you need to do a thing with Giovanni in Castletown when we were on our way to meet Princess Zelda for the second time. But regardless, where it starts doesn't really matter because you can't actually start collecting postals until after you've met with Zelda, and it's pretty much a wise idea to do that first and foremost before, get the Master Sword before, go on out and do any pole hunting, because that's going to take a long time to get all 60 of the poles, and we can't even get all of them until close to the end of the game, but we get I think at least half of them by now. I'm not entirely sure because we're roughly at the halfway point in the game, but there are some in other areas which we can't access just yet. But there are a lot hanging out in the Hyrule field that we can access currently. Anywho, we're gonna put that conversation aside. You got this part, this little fishing hole inside the fishing hole. there, and there's a sign to the right, off to the right here, that says, "Don't litter, do not toss empty bottles or cans here. The fish are crying. Keep the fishing hole clean." Well, looks like someone's up to no good. Some no good litter bug. So, let's say we do them a little favor and try to get some of that rubble out of the fishing hole. There we go, we got one. Unfortunately, we just got another green gill. Not what I wanted. I guess we're gonna have to try again. Fish on! Still not what I wanted. Fish on! Number 3. There we go. We got it. We got our third empty bottle. So, we can use it. Same as any other bottle. We got 3, of course. Got the one with the lantern oil. The very first one, which had the milk in it. We actually fished to get the green gill for the cat. And then, what was her name? Sarah, I think? Had milk in the bottle, and she gave us the leftovers. And that was our first one, and we bought the one from Goro, and now we got the number 3 here. So, typically in most of the games there are 4 empty bottles. And the fourth one in this game is a doozy to get, so we're pretty much stuck with those 3 for the time being. For a long time, that is, as well. We're not going to be able to get the fourth one so close to the end of the game, unfortunately. So, should not have spent all my rupees because I'm going to need some here, as well as to do round 2 of Deez's boat shop. So you know what? We're gonna leave the fishing hole. I'm just gonna stop by over at Agatha's castle, probably read off some bug descriptions, and then come right back here. God, I love warping. I'm going to do this right, come back with my commentary a little bit sooner than I thought, because if I'm not mistaken, we got our old friend on our way back to Hyrule Castle. Mr. Link, wait! Hey! Letter from Telma. Okay, so we got only one this time. Oh, my business is concluded. Onward to mail! Great. So we saw the postman. And what's that letter say, anyways? They came so quickly, Link. There's some folks I want you to meet, so come to my bar right away. These guys will be powerful allies for you. You heard me, come by. I'll be waiting for you at my Castletown bar. Telma. Well, I guess we got 2 things to do before the end of this episode. First of all, we're going to get some rupees from Agatha, visit Telma, and then go back to the fishing hole. We'll probably save Isa's boat shop for later, because that might take a while to complete. There's one simple thing we can do in the fishing hole to get a piece of heart, and I think that will be a wrap for this episode, because things have been getting close to an hour here already. As though, money is very important. And Agatha, of course, has a lot of it. Where she gets it all, I don't know, but she gets a lot. She has a lot of money here. Alright. Oh, I only have the snail. We're gonna go do some bug hunting in the next episode, from the looks of things, as well. So yeah, we'll give her the male snail. Actually, it might be a female. I guess you can't really tell with a snail like this, but yeah. Oh boy, who's your friend? A little male snail, aren't you, you little cutie? Little snail. Just once I'd like to take a bath in that slime. Oh boy, thank you so much. I'm so happy. So, 50 rupees as usual. Okay, so we're not going to be able to get the female snail for quite a long time. So we're going to have to try and fill in pretty much all the other slots. I think we'll be able to get at least 21 bugs at this point in time in the game. I mean, there are a couple just right outside of Castletown. We could probably get them. And there are a couple in the north field, and I think some in Lake Hillia. I'm not entirely sure, but there's like six right there. So, and then there's also some above the bridge over Lake Hillia, so that's like eight. So we can get a lot of money just by doing that. Oh, I kind of like that real quick. Let me show that again. Listen closely. Yeah, whenever you're in a heavily populated like area like this, Minda's voice clips are very hushed. She kind of whispers to you whenever she talks to you like that. Oh, hey, I just saw you, Mr. Postman. What do you want? I do believe I will start with meat. No, I'm not the waiter here. let's talk to Telma real quick. Oh my, if it isn't Link. You made it. How you been, honey? Mercy, but you have a good time, and I was just talking about you. Oh, you have good timing. Hey, everybody, introduce yourselves. This handsome young man, the infamous Link. Introductions? I guess I gotta go over to them. You remember what I told you before, honey? These are those friends I mentioned. One trying to help deal with all the troubles in Hyrule. Actually, there's one more of us, but there has been a disturbing turn of events in the Western Desert. So he's gonna check it out. It's an old man named Aruru. Or Aru. I put an extra R in there. Whoops. If you're having a meeting, definitely take time to talk with him, okay, honey? Well, you come all the way here, honey, so why don't you relax a bit? Why don't you be sociable and talk to these folks? They're a jolly bunch. Silent protagonist lady, we don't really do any of the talking here. didn't say anything. It's been a long time, Link. Oh, hey, it's Russell. My wife, Uli, sent word to me. I have seen the children in Kakariko Village. And of course, I have also heard of your adventures. I must thank you for your help with Colin, Link. I barely recognized him. In any case, I am troubled by my own inaction. I want to help the cause, these friends here. I have had a connection with them for a long while. Like the others, I am gathering information now. I will let you know if I hear anything. Well, it's our old pal Russell back from Oran Village. Looks like he's all healed up and wielding that sword arm for a good cause. He still is the ultimate badass of Oran Village, even though I'm also from there. Oh, hello there. You must be Link, correct? I am Shad. Wonderful to meet you. Why am I getting so tongue-tied on this? Telma told me all you've been up to. You're rather formidable. I'm rather not, I'm afraid. Well, I'm formidable at book reading, but I lack, shall we say, physical skills. That said, if history and legends of Hyrule are your cup of tea, I'm your fellow. If you're curious, just ask away. At the moment, I'm actually entranced by this guy being known as the Uka. Yes, according to legends, Hyrule was made by the Hylians, who, as we all know, are the closest race to the gods. But according to legend, long ago, there was a race even closer to the gods. Some say these creatures made the Hylians. When they created the people of Hylia, they simultaneously created a new capital, a city that floated in the heavens. They dwelt there, and some scholars believe that this race lives there still, somewhere in the great sky. Sky beings, since that simply marvelous old boy, but I wouldn't give to meet them. Anything else you gotta say now? Oh, just still gathering information. Well, we haven't given you much time to do that. For you, I'm Ashy. Or it's Ashy. I grew up in the mountains with my father, who was a knight in his own right. He taught me the arts of war as though I was his son. Of course, lessons in common courtesy were not part of the regiment, so forgive me if I come off as rude, yeah? Are you a boy or are you a girl? I probably shouldn't ask that. Well, looking at your assets, I think I can tell. But you said he raised you as you were his son? I guess figure of speech, we'll leave it at that. Listen, before I blab both of your ears off, I want to tell you something. Snow Peak, it's the mountain north of Hyrule. It's unlike any mountain I've ever known. I don't know much about it yet, but things there that happen no other mountain I know of. Evil controls it, and as soon as I know something more, I'll tell you. Until then, you just stay away, yeah? Alright, so... Yep. She's a girl, even though... She said this whole sun thing there. Better look at everybody here. Shed, bit of a bookworm, of course. He and Russell got his own helmet and set of armor that we never saw back in Ornan Village. Anywho, yeah, we met with Telma and the gang, and there's one last thing we can do. Yeah, what we are going to do before we end off this episode, so I'm going to do that real quick. Back to the fishing hole, and yes, you can warp here in the back alley, because there's no one here to see you do it. And transforming the wolf and all that. So, gotta love warping. I think it's nighttime, so that'll also be a good thing for the start of the next episode, where we start hunting down a bunch of those poes. Yes, that's gonna be a bit of a pain, but we're gonna try and get as much of it done as soon as possible. Although, transform back in the game. And there should be the entrance to the fishing hole right here. Alright. So, knock knock, are you awake at this time of night, Miss Little Lady that we never met? Oh, he's digging this place. Then again, we must have liked fishing back in Ordon if Colin himself would go out of his way to make us a little fishing pole of ours. Hi there! Hey, you! Never been here before, have you? Well, I'm the owner of this fishing hole. My name's Hina. Nice to meet ya. 20 rupees to try some lure fishing. There's no time limit and the canoe rental's included. Wanna give it a shot? Sure.
Okay.
Well, seeing how this is your first time and all, I'll throw in the guide service for free. Let's get fishing. However, we'll deal with this place a little bit later. You can pretty much do anything there is to do here right now, as soon as we're able to do it. But there is one thing important. You can probably see it glinting there on the rocks over there. So, we're going to get some distance away, and we'll try and toss our lure up there. And got it first try! Normally you'll have to reel that in, but I was close enough to actually pull it up. What's that, a piece of heart? Oh my, whose heart did you catch, you big sweetheart? Don't be shy, this wasn't yours to keep. I guess that does kind of throw into question, what exactly is a piece of heart? But we could fish if we wanted to. We're probably going to do that sometime down the road. Probably between a couple of dungeons once we've cleaned up most of the side quests between here and then. So we're going to call it quits here. That's all I really wanted to grab was the piece of heart. Oh, all done? Too bad this time. Oh well, it happens. We wasted 20 rupees and didn't catch a single fish, but we got a piece of heart. Well, better luck next time. And you can actually take a look around your little hut here. There's so much to do, so much to see, and there's also a little mini game here on the table here if you want to play it. It's basically just like I don't know if anyone knows about this game these days, but when I was a kid, there was this little box game called Labyrinth, and you had to navigate a little marble through the maze and try to get all the way to the end without it falling into any holes. This is kind of the same thing, but instead, this is called Roll Goal, and we gotta try and... not do that. We gotta try and be very careful and use basic inertia to roll the marble into the goal at the very end. And just kinda have to use a bit of a feather touch on this if you want to be successful. And I've actually done this all the way to the very end. There's like, I think 64 levels of this. I think there's like 8 levels and I think there's 80 levels. I'm not entirely sure. But I think there's 8 levels, and then it repeats with less time. And I think you can do it like 5 or 10 times, I'm not really sure. But yeah, there's a lot of these, and you can actually do this. You get plenty of time at the beginning here. And this is just to kind of get your finger trained up to do this the right way the first few times. But eventually, things will get harder, and you have less time to do it. But yeah, you'll get a little bit of money each time you do it. It costs 5 rupees to play. And you gotta leave the shop every time you want to play the next stage, no course. But yeah, there's a lot to do here, a lot to see. And yeah, this is how you figure out his name. Koro. I was close. I kept calling him Goro. But it's Koro. And yes, he's a relative of Hina here. 25-inch Ordon catfish, and a 25-inch Ordon catfish he caught. It's the only one in our family who's lousy at fishing. Managed to catch that fish by using a singing lure. Cheater. Okay, so singing lures are forbidden. A thing about my lazy brother, asked him to drop by and help out from time to time, but he never does. Can't fish a lick, so he spends his time in the woods talking to the animals. He's kind of worthless, yeah. He runs a lantern shop and gives away free lanterns. If that ain't worthless, then I don't know what is. Can we look at the books? Anything interesting to say? Yeah, if you use a C-stick to look around, she talks about this and that. What about this little birdie here? So cute, isn't she? Her name's Purdy. She even talks sometimes. And there's one thing I want to look at over there, if I can, and the lures over there. I can only fish while floating lures here, and I'll lend out 3 different types. Basic lure is a swimmer type, but also I have poppers and spinners. And also I have a frog type, but that's kind of tough to use. Well, other than that, the people who can beat the game next to the door. So I think in order for us to get the frog lure, which we'll get into lures and stuff later, but I think you have to beat level 1 of all the stages on her little roll goal thing there. So, we might do that later. I also think you can get the frog lure if you catch one of every type of fish in the fishing hole. But aside from that, you know, we'll do more stuff here in detail there. Also, I'm not going to do this right now, as I'm going to warn you. Do not mash A and roll around while you're inside of her shop, because she will get pissed at you if you try to knock down her pots off the walls. There's always one character in every Zelda game that hates it when you smash their pots, and she is the one. So yes, do not piss off the pretty little lady, because she might prevent you from using the fishing hole altogether. So, yeah, mind your manners, and mind your P's and Q's, little lad. Because this is southern territory. No, actually, we're in the north. What am I saying? I am not going to get into stereotyping here. I'm just going to leave the fishing hole. And we're going to save the game here. And we're going to call it a day. So, this is SIMSteven, also known as Mr. Friendle, saying thanks for watching. And I hope to see you guys next time.